Well, there's a big controversy out there. Bomani Jones wears this t-shirt on ESPN and the whole internet goes wild. Apparently, it was even called a Twitter moment. Whatever a Twitter moment is, I can guess that it means a big deal on Twitter. I'll be honest with you. I don't use Facebook and I don't use Twitter. I believe that they are tools for the globalists. And remember, there are two types of people now in this world. You're either a globalist for a new world order, a one currency for the whole world, or you're a nationalist and you're for American ideas, okay? I happen to be an American. I happen to be a nationalist. And I know who the enemy is. The enemy is the globalist. So let's get right to the story. The story is about Bomani Jones wearing this stupid t-shirt in front of all the young people and stirring up a bunch of trouble. Number one, this t-shirt does not offend me in any way, shape, or form. Anybody who thinks this t-shirt is offensive has probably been a brainwashed child in the public school system, and their brain needs a total reboot. Yes, this is just a diversion. Let's go into it, their agenda on the surface. When I say the surface agenda, what the globalists want you to think, or more importantly, what they want the young people to think. And what the globalists want the young people to think is it's the white man's fault. Yes, all those white people who cannot find a job, they are the enemy. Yes, it's so funny. All these white people now who don't, they have to work 3 part-time jobs to barely get by, they're the enemy. So it's a diversion away from the globalist, okay? When you look at the people who are really in charge, who own all the TV stations, who own all the newspapers, who own everything, we've been into that 1,000 times, okay? The globalists are in charge of everything. It's the globalists' fault that the jobs have been moved out of the country. And of course, so the true agenda here is to get the young people, their minds diverted, to get their minds distracted away from the truth, that it's really the globalists who are the enemy, who have destroyed America, who have taken all the jobs out of America, who have devalued the dollar, and all the problems that the young people are feeling today is a direct result of what the globalists have been doing for over 50 years. And so, what would the globalists have to do? Their plan is very simple. Distract the young people, put diversions out there. And of course, the biggest diversion is the public school system. We know that. The kids are brainwashed into public schools. Oh, you can't talk about this, you can't talk about that. And of course, if you take away this freedom of speech, that's what it's all about, isn't it? If you take away the freedom of speech, you're not allowed to have this logo. You're not allowed to call these people that. You're not allowed to call these people this. You take away free speech, and then you take away their ability to have an original thought. And what are you left with? You're left with a young person who's nothing more than a robot who has been programmed to think one way, and that way is the way of the globalist. That's how they're going to take over the world, by brainwashing the children. This is nothing but a diversion away from the truth. This is just one of the many diversions that the globalists will use to distract the young people. This whole video today is directed towards the young people. I know that the older generations, they already know what I'm telling you. Some of the people who listen to me, you guys already know this. I'm speaking to the choir, so to speak. But this video is, if there's any young people out there at all who listen to me, this is to wake up the young people that there are many, many diversions out there to distract you, to take your eye off the ball. What you're looking at here is nothing but a diversion by the globalist to make you think that a politically correct world is the best way, when in fact, this politically correct world that they're trying to push down our throats is what is going to take away all of our freedoms. And then the globalist will easily be able to have a one-world government. The globalist will easily be able to have a currency that's for the whole world, but it'll be a fake digital currency where they push the buttons, you will always be poor and their people will always be rich. That means you will be a slave and they will be the master. That is their agenda. Their agenda is to shut down people like me. They don't want people like me to spread the truth. And the truth is, what are the globalists up to? And I know that the globalists are up to no good. And I know that these little things that they push, this is just a tiny little thing. Like I said, this t-shirt does not offend me in any way. And in many ways, I like this t-shirt. This t-shirt, to me, says, yes, stop using the word white. White is just the word that they're going to use against you. Oh, the white man did it. The white man did all, it is the bad guy. The white guy is the bad guy. Forget about that. There is no white people. You are part of the European tribes of North America. You should be proud of who you are. That's why I founded the European tribes of North America, because you should be proud of who you are. And that is a name that they will not be able to attack you on. Think about that. If you call yourself a European, and you're part of the European tribes of North America, nobody can attack you. You see, that's what I want to teach the young people today. Forget the word white. Don't use the word white anymore. You are a Caucasian. So in many ways, I like this t-shirt. It teaches our young people, be proud to be a Caucasian. The Caucasians have done many, many good things. Pretty much every invention that was ever created was either created by a Caucasian or an Asian. But are any of us perfect? No, none of us are perfect. We have much work to do. But letting the globalists turn us into zombies and robots is not the right path. See, we have to fight this. We have to tell the young people, don't be fooled by their diversions. Think an original thought. Don't let the globalists tell you what to think. Don't let the globalists tell you that you're bad. Oh, you're part of this bad group that 100 years ago they did this bad and they did that bad, and you should feel ashamed of yourself. Hell no. We are not going to feel ashamed. We are going to stand up. We are going to protect our rights. We are not going to let the globalists tell us what to do, what to think. We are not going to let the globalists take away our guns, and we're not going to let the globalists tell us what to say. I know they're going to come and try to attack me in the future. They're going to try to stop what you're hearing today. They're going to try to stop people from, like me, from telling the truth. They've already started it with guys like Pete Santilli. They put Pete Santilli in jail. You no longer hear his voice. And that is a crime. What the globalists have done, Pete Santilli has done no crime by sharing his opinion. It's the globalists who have put him in jail that's the criminal. And one day, we are going to put our foot down and we are going to set the globalists on their path out of our country. We are going to let the globalists know that they're not welcome in America anymore. You see, this is America. We are nationalists. We have to think about an American agenda. We don't need a new world order. We don't need globalists telling us what to say and do. And I hope I got my point across, that this t-shirt is nothing but a diversion that the globalists are using to distract our young people into zombies and robots who can be easily programmed. And they're probably almost halfway done with their agenda. The globalists are very close to winning the war if we don't wake up and smell the coffee soon.